All right, we got the 2-inch rigid foam going in. We're gonna tape all those seams. Just waiting on the tape to arrive, and we'll go through that, show you everything, what we gotta do. Let me run you over here real quick, show you how to install it, clean the footing. So always make sure your corners are taped tight, and then we just seal that with some Gorilla tape. But on the foundation, you got these wall ties. Just make sure they're all cleaned up, all the concrete around them like this. Usually got a big hunk of concrete. We just chip it off. Probably could find one with concrete on it somewhere. Well, maybe not. We cleaned them the other day. But anyways, you can see where there was the concrete. Yeah, on the other side of the wall, you can see them. So there's hunks like that on all the wall ties. You hit all that off. Make sure your footing is clean like this, where it comes out from the forms. Clean that footing with a chisel or whatever, and then push your foam in down tight to the other one. And then if you get it there and you push it right in, and it squeezes in those wall ties and it holds it good. And then we put some foam sealer up here, which is just like caulk, to hold that in. And we'll get a video of that in a little bit. So on the corners, we use just a regular saw. We cut it down just like that. Flush it like that. It's just a regular hand saw. You could use a hot knife too, and we'll use that when we do all the interior in here, because we got to cut out for interior footing walls, and we'll have 6 inches of foam, so we'll have to use a hot knife to go down in, and it makes a nice and clean cut. All right, taping the seams, we just use regular Gorilla tape, works real well. Make sure it's tight, and just run this right down like so. Make sure it's nice and flush. Alright, so we run the caulk down like this, and then we tape the foam back to the foundation to hold it till it dries. This is just regular foam caulk you get at Depot, and let it run down in, and then we clean it up. Alright, just after lunch, we got all the foam on. We got our resin paper down covering the stone, so when the backfill material goes on to this, we're using the existing soil that's here for the outside. It doesn't go into the stone and contaminate it, and then that resin paper rots away after a month and it stabilizes the ground, so it can't go down in because the ground will be stable at that point. Everything's caulked here with the foam glue, so this holds. And there's a chalk line, we're 10 inches down from the top of that foam, which will give us 8 inches from the top of the wall, because there's a 2-inch higher on the foam, 2-inch lip there. All right, we're gonna start backfilling now.
Do what you gotta do.
and backfilling this foundation. It was way too hard to cut with the dozer, but we were trying to get the grade. The grade has to come down severely to that red line. You probably can't see it, but it's about 10 inches down below that top of foam. got that hill all knocked down so the water can get out behind the corner of his house, but he's still gonna have a big bank in the house. We'll taper that. Nothing you can do about that. End of the day, we got all this backfilled. He's just great tapering this hill off a little bit better. You remember, this was all 4 foot down in the front here, so it's all filled up. We got a lot of that hill cut out. We'll take out a little more tomorrow, but we're not gonna go crazy on that because that's existing and that wasn't in the contract. So we got all this backfilled. The other side of the garage, the only spot we got left is in front of the house. We'll grab that in the morning. And we're good to go.